Hey, Tay here, so welcome to the VRTech channel. Welcome back to the True Lenses series, the series where we stick a camera in front of the lenses, our VR headsets, to see which one is the best, which one is the right for you. And yes, we are doing another one because you guys ask constantly since the Quest 2 review to compare it with the HP Reverb G2, the headset with the highest resolution on the market right now. And it's actually quite insane, the fact that I'm probably the only person in the entire world with both the Quest 2 and the Reverb G2. Shoot. So, well, yeah, let's make it. In this video, I'm gonna compare the upcoming Oculus Quest 2 with the resolution of 1832 by 1920 with an LCD display with RGB pixel arrangement running up to 90 Hz. By the way, more about that in a few. And the also upcoming HP Reverb G2 with the resolution of 2160 by 2160 each eye RGB pixel arrangement LCD display running at 90 Hz. And the only one that you can have already in your hands, the Valve Index with the resolution of 1440 by 1600 LCD display with RGB pixel arrangement running up to 144 Hz. Now, comparing these three headsets is a little weird because on the side we have the Quest 2 that is a standalone headset, so it doesn't even need the PC most of the time. Well, yeah, well, in this video we are using Link, of course, to display it, and in the last part actually something else. And the G2, that is a PC VR headset directly from HP running on Windows Mixed Reality that has a very, very high resolution native PC VR, and at the same time the Valve Index that gives the best of experience actually for the refresh rate of the display and not really for the resolution. And we're actually comparing a $300 headset with a $600 headset and with a $1,000 headset. So, yeah. I don't know, guys, you asked, like, let's do it. Before to get to the video, though, some reminders. The first one is we're running an Oculus Quest 2 giveaway. It's gonna be in the description below. Second part is the Link is running on a preview of the November update. I didn't super sample it, so it's exactly the native resolution like all the others. The third part is that at the end of the video, we're gonna talk more about what's particular about the last part that I added about DCS, because that is gonna be mind-blowing. And as I always say, this is not a science. These lenses, these screens are made for your eyes and not for the lenses of a camera. So take your own conclusions, see what you wanna see, and let's talk more about it at the end of the comparison. Let's get into it. We'll be right back. And here you have it, guys. This was the comparison between the Oculus Quest 2, the Reverb G2, and the Valve Index. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you guys enjoyed the new part with DCS. I know that I promised before that I was going to do a DCS video also with the Reverb G2. I also promised that I was doing a comparison with the Quest 2. So I said, whatever, let's put everything together and let's make people happy. So if you liked it, please drop a like below so more people can see it and more people can see what these headsets are capable of. Now, making this comparison was very fun because we are actually comparing three headsets as three different markets completely, where the Oculus Quest 2, for the mainstream market to bring VR to everyone with their standalone capabilities, the HP Reverb G2 is the headset with the maximum resolution. You want to cramp all the details possible with a price that is not as high as other high-end headsets. And the Valve Index at the highest price gives you an experience that is not possible in any other headset with 144 refresh rate, and also having the lighthouse for tracking technology, being able to have full body tracking and stuff like that, also index controllers, everything a little more to the extreme, of course. So bear in mind that this part is just a comparison about the mirror screen, where we don't really see even the refresh rate over there. And I said that I was going to talk a little bit about it. Stay tuned for tomorrow, because I'm going to talk more about Link, and I'm going to talk more about the 90 Hertz refresh rate on my Oculus Quest 2 that you saw on the DCS part. You heard it correctly, 90 Hertz. Now, me and Mike from Virtual Reality Oasis, we collaborated with the virtual desktop guy, and we were able to actually bring the 90 Hertz refresh rate already to the Oculus Quest 2. Of course, it's still experimental. Of course, it's not something that you can download on your Quest 1. It's not something that anybody can download, because we are still in testing right now, but the results are pretty epic, and I wanted just to share a little sneak peek over there. But yeah, super excited to share more about it tomorrow, so stay tuned. But so far, comparing these three screens, I have to say that the G2 really crushed it already when it comes to resolution. The clarity is just insane in everything you look at. When you put it on, you really have the wow factor that really miss with other headsets. And probably I didn't have this wow factor with the Quest 2 because I was so spoiled already by the Reverb G2. That doesn't mean that the Quest 2 is not good. It's actually very, very good, because the screen door effect is pretty much gone over there as well. We don't have much of a difference in resolution in mere pixels. On the other side, though, not having a display port but using still a USB or wireless, of course, we're not gonna have the same resolution output in the headset. So that means that we're gonna have a little artifacts and stuff like that, but the result is still amazing. And I have to say that it kind of looks pretty much like the Index, or even a little better sometimes, because there's less screen door effect. Of course, without taking into consideration that the Index is running 144 Hertz, it's really an experience to try, because that's just super freaking smooth. I'm not gonna go super in depth on this topic, by the way, because I think that I could talk for 20 more minutes about it. But I heard that many people are actually canceling the G2 order for the Oculus Quest 2. And on a way, I don't blame you, because it's half of the price and you still have a very good experience. On the other one, if you were grabbing the Reverb G2 for mirror resolution, well, there's nothing even close to that yet. So take that as you wish. By the way, guys, I see you tomorrow with a video more specific about the Link and also about the 90 Hertz mode that I'm trying right now. Super excited to share more about it. And yeah, for now, if you liked the video, like. If you didn't like the video, dislike. Subscribe to the channel for more VR tech. And if you really love the channel, there's a join button down there. And also the Patreon in the description below that has access to this video prior the release. So if you want to be the first one to see this stuff and many, many others content, well, check out the Patreon. And in the description below, we also have the merchandise with the t-shirt, sticker, and mask. 2020 item number one. But for me is all. I see you guys tomorrow and also the day after. So like, dislike, subscribe. See you guys next video. Thanks for watching. Ciao.